Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 5 basic techniques that every Mac user should know. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the first technique I want to show you is context menus. Context menus are what you get when you hold down the Control key and click on an object on your screen. You get this menu here that allows you to perform actions on that object. You can also get context menus by using 2 fingers on the trackpad or right clicking on a mouse. Anytime you need to perform an action and you're not sure how to go about doing it, think of the object on the screen that you want to perform the action on and try bringing up its context menu. You can see it works for files here, but it works for other things as well. I can control click on the toolbar at the top, for instance. I can control click on the blank space here in the Finder window. I can control click on items in the sidebar. I can control click on the desktop. In other apps like Pages here, I can control click on an image. I can control click on some text. You can control click just about anywhere and it will show you commands that can be performed on that object. So often I get questions from people about how they would do something, and the answer is often control clicking on that object, and then that command is revealed in the context menu. The next technique I want to show you is the app switcher. The app switcher is what you get when you hold down the command key and then you press tab. That brings up the app switcher and it shows you all the apps that are currently running on your Mac. As long as you continue to hold down the command key, the app switcher will stay there and you can press tab to continue to move along it. And when you get to the app that you want to use, simply release the command key and it brings that app to the front. So while you're using your Mac and you have various apps open, it's easy to use the app switcher to switch between them. You don't need to go and try to relaunch the app if it's already running. You can also do other things with the app switcher. A quick command tab will simply switch to the previous app and command tab will switch back. So you can switch quickly between 2 apps with quick presses of command tab. You can also use command tab and then keep holding the command key down, and as you tab through you can use Q to quit an app and H to unhide and hide it. Which brings me to my next technique, which is hiding apps. A lot of people will just quit an app when they want to get to something behind it or use another app. But you can just hide an app, keep it going, and this keeps the window in the current position, the dock or docks you have opened, even things like selected text, selected, ready to go. And you could just use command H to hide an app. Then you could bring it back with the app switcher, or you can just go into the dock and click on the app in the dock and you could see the app was still there with the same thing selected, the same position in the document and everything. Sometimes people quit apps still thinking it's like 20 years ago when memory management was an issue and leaving an app running, even if it was hidden, was taking up some sort of chunk of memory. But that's not how Mac OS works. It manages memory really well and it's perfectly fine to leave lots of apps running at the same time and hide the ones you're not using currently. I only really quit apps if I know I'm not going to be using them again, say, for the rest of the day. Now sometimes it's not necessary to run an app at all. For instance, if you want to view an image file, you can select it and simply bring up Quick Look. You can do so by pressing the space bar. That brings up the Quick Look window. It's a window you can move around, you can resize, and you can view an image. But not just an image. You could also view other things. For instance, here's a numbers document. I can pretty clearly see what's inside of it just by pressing the space bar to use Quick Look. I can press the space bar again to dismiss it. I can even listen to sounds, view videos, and do something with just about every type of file. You can even leave the Quick Look window open and use the arrow keys to move between files. So if I move the Quick Look window over here, you can see I've got this file selected. If I use the right arrow, you can see it moves over to the next file. And if I switch, say, to List View, I can simply use Quick Look and then down arrow to go between all the files and view what's in there. There are other ways to view previews as well. For instance, if I take this Finder window here, I can go to View and then Show Preview. And it will show me a preview, just like Quick Look, here on the right side. And I can do that in List View. I can see that in Column View as well. Even Icon View can have a preview here on the right. And you can always turn it off by going to View, Hide Preview. Now the last basic technique I want to show you is Mission Control. And this allows you to have multiple desktops instead of just one. Think of it like having multiple screens. Say you have a MacBook, you've got one screen, but let's pretend you have two, but you can only see one at a time. If you use Control, not Command, but Control and up arrow, you could see at the top here, Desktop 1. I could add another desktop by clicking the plus button here. And now it's like I have two screens on my Mac. I could drag a window or even more over to the second desktop. Now let's go to that second desktop and you can see I've got these two app windows open here. Control app arrow brings me back and I can go back to desktop one where I've got these windows open here. An easier way to get between them is use control right and left arrows. So control right arrow brings me over to this desktop. Control left arrow brings me back over to here. Mission Control also works with full screen apps. So for instance, let's take calendar full screen by clicking on the green button here. Now when I do control up arrow, you can see I've got desktop 1, desktop 2, and then the full screen app calendar. So now I can choose which one I want to see, and I could still use control right arrow to move between them one direction, control left arrow in the other direction. So those are five basic Mac techniques that every Mac user should master. Doing so will increase your productivity and allow you to get the most from your Mac. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.